Hey guys, it's Tina Sheth here at Rebalance Physical Therapy and Wellness in Center City, Philadelphia, as well as on the Main Line in Narberth, Pennsylvania. Today, I'm going to address to all of you men, which I know so many of you men are dealing with this, is problems with sexual functioning or erectile dysfunction that accompanies pain. Pain either in the lower abdominals, pain in the buttock, rectal, genital area, penis, testicles, scrotum, epididymis, you name it. Down there in the sexual organs, you guys are having pain or in and around that in addition. And maybe for some of you men, you're also having bladder issues, constipation issues, like I said, lower abdominal issues, and maybe a whole host of other things like hip pain, low back pain, all that kind of stuff. But specifically, I want to address the pelvic pain, okay, which that everything that I just talked about falls into the category of pelvic pain, and this erectile dysfunction issue. Now, I know it's been frustrating because I bet you some of you men have gone to see, whether it's your general doctor, whether it's a urologist, maybe there's a specialist, hormone specialist, I don't know. You guys have seen all these doctors. And some of you are very young. Some of you guys are in your 20s and 30s and you shouldn't be having erectile dysfunction. But you go, you seek a physician's help and they're basically wanting to put you guys on Viagra or these male enhancement medications. But really for you, you guys feel that there's nothing wrong with me. I'm young. Maybe some of you are older, but you still are feeling that, hey, I shouldn't necessarily need to be on these medications. Now, erectile dysfunction can have many different components, okay? So there could be hormonal influences, there could be vascular issues, vascular meaning like your circulation. There could be neurological issues, okay? Meaning the nerves aren't functioning well down there. But one of the areas, especially for those of you who can't pinpoint why this might be going on in terms of has there been some type of neurological issue? Or has there been a change significant in your hormones? If you cannot relate it to some of those issues or trauma or something like that, then a good chance is that for many of you men, this is a muscular issue. And you're gonna know that that there's a higher correlation because if you are also having pain that accompanies when you are perhaps having, pain in general down there, but perhaps you're also having pain with an erection, with ejaculation, after having intercourse, but you're also noticing maybe that's what started to happen, but now it's turning into this erectile dysfunction. You're not able to get an erection. Perhaps you guys are having changes to how the penis is functioning. Maybe it feels softer than it normally should. Maybe it feels harder but smaller than it normally should. Something that I have another video about hard flaccid syndrome. But I want to talk to you men about what might be going on. So, because I know that this, for some of you, can lead to a lot of anxiety, depression, and many other things, okay? You aren't necessarily depressed about this, but now this issue has caused the depression. So, perhaps some of you guys are getting on medication that you shouldn't necessarily need to be on, for depression. So anyway, so what is going on? So first you have to understand, or I need to explain, that when men have an erection, basically we're looking at, this is the pelvis, okay? So if this is a female model, but I'm gonna show you with the picture on the male model, okay? This is the pelvis of your body. Now underneath here, you actually have a lot of this red stuff, which is actually musculature. And on the male, the penis comes up from here. So this is what we're looking at, okay? Inside this red, this is musculature, and it's the muscles called your pelvic floor. So we're gonna look at this picture right over here. So this is what a male model looks like. There's the penis right in through here. We're looking at the underside, okay, underneath this, on this picture. Here is the tailbone. Here are the hip joints right in through here. So your hips come down here, and then your legs come down through here. There is your pubic bone, should be like right underneath here, okay? Or right above the penis, but in this archway. So that way you guys have some reference of what we're looking at. All of this is what's called the pelvic floor musculature in the male. Now, the way that men have an erection, I'm gonna keep this very simple because you can get into a significant amount of medical terminology, but this is actually a closed hydraulic system that is dealing with blood flow. So when there, when the veins do not allow what's called return of the blood flow back up towards the heart, okay? So it's called the venous system. You've got your arteries, you've got your veins. When you are having arousal, okay, basically this, the musculature, the blood basically pools in this area, okay, doesn't allow venous return, so you get this blood in this area. And then it allows that blood to kind of engorge in through here, which is part of the pelvic floor musculature. These muscles contract, and with that blood flow in through the system, as well as these muscles contracting, this creates an erection. Now, what has happened, okay, for some of you men who might be experiencing pain in the penis, scrotum, epididymis area, lower abdominals, rectum, perineum, and this whole area, maybe some hip pain, back pain, all that kind of stuff, tailbone pain. What has happened is this musculature possibly has become tight and it's become spasmed. And when that happens, you're not going to get good, efficient functioning of these muscles, but you're also not going to get good blood flow. So remember, you need two of those things in order to have an erection. You need to have the contractibility, but you also need to have the blood flow in through this area to get that erection. Now, if you don't have that, okay, then you're going to end up having potentially erectile dysfunction. You're not going to be able to have an erection that feels like it's your normal erection. Either it's, you know, it you get blood in this area that pools, but you don't get lengthening of the penis, or you don't get an erection that lasts long. So basically, this musculature, if it's tight and it's contracted, you're not going to get good blood flow. Now, I can get into all the reasons why this happens, but I'm not using this video to kind of get into that, because I have so many other videos as to why that happens. And I'll tell you about how you can learn more about that a little bit later. But basically, if this becomes tight and contracted, you're not going to get that blood flow. But this is the other thing. For some of you men, you're also dealing with, well, when I have an erection or when I do ejaculate, I actually have pain. Now, what is going on with that? Well, remember I said, some of these muscles of the pelvic floor contribute to that erection. Now, if you already have spasming and tightness within this musculature, when you go to have an erection and ejaculation, these muscles contract. So now you're basically taking these muscles that are already tight, don't have good blood flow, are probably irritable. And if you have spasming in it, just to give you an idea, you know, when you press on like your upper trap when you're having neck pain, okay, say if you're, you take your fingers and you kind of press over here. If you press on some of that musculature in your upper trap, it actually is going to feel tight and tender. And that might actually be giving some of you guys tension headaches or neck pain. Well, imagine this is the same idea. These muscles are no different than other muscles in the body. So if these muscles become tight and contracted, then you're actually also going to have pain. And if they contract more, okay, so if these upper trap muscles contract more and you're doing this all day, imagine how much more that's going to contribute to your neck pain. So this is kind of the same idea that's going on. If these muscles are already tight and then they contract through an erection as well as ejaculation, then that's going to cause pain. So does that make sense to some of you guys who are wondering, like, why am I having this? And why can't urologists or other doctors explain to me what's going on? Well, this is what potentially is going on. And if you've gone to your urologist, if you've gone to your doctors, they're not finding anything. Your hormones aren't changed. You don't have any neurological conditions. They don't have any plausible reason as to why this is happening. Then this is a big likelihood that it could be contributing to your problems. Now, what do you do about it? So, you know, we see a lot of men at our clinic here in Pennsylvania, Philadelphia, Narberth, okay? We treat a ton of men. We see tons of patients from out of town, out of state, because they come to actually see us because we understand this. We've been treating this for 18 to 20 something years, each of us therapists at our clinic. So, we had to actually develop a program, because what we were doing is we were doing a lot of case management. I was doing a lot of case management consultation via video because of COVID. And so we actually ended up having to develop, like, what can you guys do at home? Because some couldn't get to our clinic. Some of you, maybe you have other physical therapists that you're seeing, but you couldn't get to the clinic. So we actually ended up developing a program to actually teach you guys to be able to do this and start getting this improved from home. So that you can learn how to do these techniques. So you can learn how to make a lot of this musculature improve in circulation, decrease the tensioning, and hopefully this starts to improve any of the erectile dysfunction that you're having. And also, most importantly, decreasing the pain that you might be having. That's like first and foremost. I'm sure that creates anxiety and depression in some of you guys. Like, what is going on? And then, of course, that makes you recede from trying to engage in sexual activity. Right? Pain. If something causes you pain, why would you want to engage in sexual activity? So we actually ended up developing a program. It's a 4 to 5 hour program, and it actually keeps increasing because we keep making it better based on your guys' feedback that we're hearing from you and based on our continuous research into this area of the pelvic floor, going to conferences and talking to a lot of other really great minds when it comes to trying to help you men tackle this problem, because it's a huge problem. So we actually developed a program. All of our information is actually in the information box underneath. And we have our male pelvic pain program in there. There's a 30-minute free PowerPoint presentation that I go through to kind of talk to you about why this might be happening, because I didn't get into that in this video. But just go through that, and at least for your own benefit to learn, watch that free presentation. But then we also have the program that accompanies that you guys can start doing right at home, and it's actually somewhat interactive because you can email us questions. The other thing is we have lots of other YouTube videos, so subscribe to our channel, because every single time I feel like I talk to one of you guys on a case management consult or I'm hearing the same things over and over again, I create a video about it so I can educate all of you men out there as to what's going on. And I've been doing this for a really, really long time. So all of the information I put out here, it's also based on evidence. It's not just our, part of it is based on our clinical experience because we see this a lot, but also a big chunk of it is based on evidence. But that evidence isn't like, this is not a popular subject that you're reading in magazines, okay? We want to put this information out there because we know this has been so helpful for so many of you. We've been doing this for a couple of years now. So we also do case management calls for, so if you guys in particular want to talk to one of us and really understand your case and what's been going on, that has been tremendously helpful for so many patients. And you can see when you click on our program, we have a lot of testimonials on there of how we've helped. And you can also just look at our Google reviews. We have amazing reviews online. So sorry, I'm going to stop talking, but I hope this video was helpful for so many of you. And like I said, subscribe to us because we will constantly pushing out content. Have a wonderful day and take care.